first game, Sveta about to serve, love out.
I feel like now would be a good time to point out the difference in equipment between these two. Soetebu using spinny rubber on both sides, more typical of professionals. Ito with short pips on the backhand. So that means she's going to be mixing up the rotation, playing a lot of flatter, faster shots from the backhand. But also she'll introduce side spin and all sorts of variety during her game.
Ito goes through her patented ritual before the serve. She eyeballs the table, start, and prepares. You're down by a point. Good shot there by Soetebu. She was able to punch that backhand by Ito on the forehand side.
This is the highest I've ever seen Ito presenting the ball before the toss. Normally, players go just barely above the table. And the reason for that is if you contact the ball, you have to throw the ball at least 6 inches high, about 16 centimeters. So you want to contact it as low to the net as possible so that it stays low to the net on the bounce.
So you have to toss the ball up about 6 inches, but you can allow it to descend before you strike it, I'm presuming.
You can. The contact cannot be made under the table. It must be visible. So the ball must be tossed from over the table and contacted over the height of the table as well.
2-5.
That said, in terms of the service toss, you can't drop the ball 6 inches and then hit it. It must go upwards 6 inches from the hand, the point it leaves the hand.
It has to go straight up, too. You can't arc it in either direction.
Nearly vertical, which means no more than 30 degrees in any direction off of vertical.
Backhands sequentially there from Mima Ito to draw within two at 5-3 here early in her match against Sudhasini Soetebat from Thailand. Ito was anticipating that serve and really jumped up quickly and tried to quickly pick it off the table and swipe it in.
Tends to be her style. That shot right there is almost never played, the banana split. It's the same side spin as the banana shot, but she comes under the ball. Watch this, under and side spin. I think there's only one other player I've seen do that, Hina Hayata, but Mima Ito just constantly mixing it up. Just for context, Sudhasini Soetebu was up 5-1 at the first towel break, so Mima Ito quickly recovering. And here Soetebu does a good job of spinning it deep on the table to make sure that that flat hit shot from Mima Ito doesn't have as good of a chance. She loves to play that flat kill game, but the deeper it is, the farther from the net, the more arc and spin she needs. And if she does spin it, Soetebu's more comfortable to counter back.
Oh, beautiful forehand from Ito there. Ito has a very interesting style as she strikes the ball at him, probably more than any player I've observed thus far, kind of leaping up into the air just as she's making the strike.
Yeah, she's not an especially big person. She floats around on the court and has a lot of good movement. Ooh, back edge of the table here. A bit of fortune. Love the crowd's reaction. I will say that Thai players have shown a lot of promise recently, and this is their leader on the receive.
Powerful forehand from Ito. One of those where the opponent reaches out and grabs it with the non-paddle hand. You know you've been fooled then. rallying back to even is Ito here. Game one of the best of seven with Sudhasini Sawedabut.
We saw the strawberry come out. Nino Ito comes around the opposite side of the ball, the opposite of the banana flick. Look at this. Oh, the strawberry fast into the corner, and Sawedabut, not bothered, anticipates it well. She's clearly studied her opponent.
You made this point already, Adam, but a lot of these flips that Ito uses, it's almost like she's cutting under the ball as well as putting side spin. Very unusual from the other players that I've observed.
Yeah, she's different than anybody else in the game. She has more creativity, more variety of spins in her game, serves in her game. And she played two shots in a row there, one of which was a chop block, that last one.
Hard flat backhands there from Ito to the backhand side on Sawedabut.
And that's the right shot for Sawedabut to take. I feel like she's got the opportunity there, the open rally. You can see her shadow rehearsing what her elbow she felt did or needed to make sure didn't do.
Ito with her first lead of the match at the right time. Here's game point. And she takes it, and game one is in the books for Mima Ito. Fast serve and then a powerful forehand in combination, kind of a 1-2 punch there, Adam. Sawedabut was on the defensive from the start.
Yeah, and she almost got that lob back. Ito making a really impressive display to step around and attack. You know, mentally, it's got to be very tough when you're leading 5-1, when you're up most of game number one, have some decent opportunities, but can't capture the game for Sawedabut.
Beautiful backhand flick that time by Ito down the line on Sawedabut. As we look at Ito receiving serve, she really does get very kind of jumpy there. It's very interesting to watch how she loosens up for each shot that she receives.
2-3.
Yeah, she's got a lot of fun sort of pre-serve rituals and also just presentations. So some bounces to stay low on the receive here.
We
saw this in her match the other night against Zoresh Akashiva, that Ito had a tendency to kind of dump some serves from time to time. Get the towel break here, but she's got a very unusual, that tomahawk serve that she uses on a regular basis. It seemed like she hit it into the net quite a bit the other night.
Yeah, I think she's testing out some new serves. She's always reinventing herself.
Tremendous power on that backhand. From the technique side, Adam, it looks like she's got the paddle out in front of her, almost like punching those backhands.
That's perfect. That's exactly what it is. It's Mima punch. If you go to Japan, actually anywhere in the world who watches table tennis, anyone who knows Mima knows Mima punch and Mima smash. The forehand right there is Mima smash. The backhand is Mima punch. They're like power moves in a video game. Back edge of the table here, Sawedabut keeping it deep. I think one of the main reasons that we see more serves, at least in this tournament, other than Mima trying some new serves, but serves that are given to the opponent or into the net, it's partially because she plays such high-risk serves.
7-3.
So that's a chance she has to take, that some are going to go into the net. Sometimes they're going to miss the table, but when they're on their table, when they're on the table, they're often not received well. Sometimes outright points for Mima Ito. So a 3-point lead. Soweto Boud now up by four, trying to recapture the opportunity she created for herself in game one at the second towel break. She's the only one going to the towel. Mima-chan, as she's known, Mima Ito, is trying to find her focus here. Get that lean on the serve.
And we did get some information on the walkover for Timo Boll here at the tournament, the World Championships, and it appears that during the regular testing process related to the COVID pandemic, Wang Yang was identified as a close contact, and he is currently in self-quarantine until the result of his PCR test is learned. The jury of the tournament decided under those circumstances that Timo Boll should get a walkover, and they want to make sure everybody understands that the local organizing committee is taking all appropriate measures to test all of the close contacts and is working closely with the ITTF to ensure the successful delivery of this tournament. Of course, everybody associated with the tournament sympathizes with the circumstances that Wang Yang finds himself in, but they believe this to be the best option and the best way to go about under these circumstances.
Well, that was incredibly well said. I can't believe you just thought of that. That's really amazing. Thanks for the update. Tight match here as Mima Ito comes within 2 points and has the serves on her side.
Left, 7-9.
And a kick serve here. The ball jumps up into the edge of the racket. That spin, the danger of the serves. No timeout called yet for Soweto Boud.
Would you expect one at this point?
Yes.
Yeah.
I would. I mean, maybe not this score exactly, but she had 8-4. You know, there was a lot of commotion up here with all the news break, but quite a significant lead. I remember 8-4 at the towel break. The danger of Mima Ito doing the same, how can it not break you as a player to be ahead by that much, 2 games in a row?
And now Ito with a couple of game points. It seems to be, though, as the game progresses.
Just to be clear, 9-9.
9-9, yes. Sorry, I apologize. But it does seem as the game progresses that Ito seems to come alive as it gets closer to the important points. But Soweto Boud with at 9-9 and the serve.
Ooh, gets a chop block out of Mima-chan, but it comes long. Sutasini, nice thing about having the last two serves. That combination, that was the chop block there, that jab with the side spin. Ito quickly regretting it, saying, you had the attack, you were still in the point. No need to slow it down and allow the opponent to get in.
And that does it. Sutasini Soweto Boud takes game two. A more athletic way of approaching it, the way that Mima Ito does it.
That is the most compact backhand. It's like the Bruce Lee one-inch punch. Just a quick jab and Mima punch, it's over. She is quite an athlete, by the way. I played goalkeeper for one penalty kick with her, an upper V for her first time, no problem.
Did she bury it?
Yep.
Buried that one too.
Absolutely. A grave digger out here. That said, it is 1-1 in games. Soweto Boud evening the playing field. Two very tight games. So this match so far could be quite, I'd say, a marathon match. It's a nice receive, taking the pace off the ball, leaving it short to the forehand. Soweto Boud with great touch and placement in the short game.
Off the forehand, she finishes, but it was the two backhands that set that up. One that came off the net, and Soweto Boud did a good job of adjusting to that ball off the net just to get it back.
Yeah, there it was, that's right. It's tough, lobbing to Mima-chan. If it's right at the baseline, heavy topspin, yeah, you could win the point that way.
Adam, that's a serve I haven't seen much, that backhand slice serve with speed and pace into the corner like that. It's almost like a long fast serve, but coming off a slice backhand.
Lead service, they'll play that again.
2-3.
That is such a beautiful shot. Sutasini seeing the side spin on the ball, slowing the ball down, so she jumps forward, lunges in for that. You can see her left foot moving right under the table, accelerating forward, just perfectly finishing that shot.
Four, three.
That serve right there has been trouble on the receive. Soetebu dealing with that tomahawk, constant variation of spin to go with the side spin. So you will see players, typically the towel break is every 6 points, but when they call for sweat squad, someone to clean the sweat off the table for hygienic reasons during these special, unique times, players will go to the towel.
Oh, and Ito gets the edge of the table. Using all of the table there. She was deep to the forehand side on one shot and then off the edge on the backhand side the next one.
That was right to where the white lines meet, the very corner of the table.
3-6.
Mixing it up in the receive game, remember it, or if you're just joining us, Mima Ito. We're talking number 3 in the world, 2 different surfaces. Her forehand has the rubber for spinning the ball. Her backhand, a bit less so. Short pips, those little bumps that I'd say make for good flat hitting and change of pace. There's a look at the racket, the red side, those bumps. The black side, smooth and grippy.
Do you see the right wrist of Mima Ito wrapped up pretty tight, looks like there. But she did it in the, we saw one last night, a player last night that had kind of a whitish color bandage. This is more of what I'd call a beige color, not would mix in with the ball, because it would seem to me that anything near the hands that was white could create a distraction for the opponent.
Yeah, probably wouldn't even be allowed for the most part. Trying to think about wristbands here and there, what I've seen, if I've seen any white ones. But yeah, in general, you know, the clothing can't have too much white on it. White shirts aren't allowed at the professional level. In tournaments, even local tournaments, someone will complain. They'll be like, hey, come on, bro. Why are you wearing a white shirt? Respect me. Sweat squad here taking care of business. Sweat squad is the best squad. Dead even, 6 each, 1 game apiece. Already an outstanding match.
Ooh. Ito gets the break there. Not only hits the top of the net and goes over it, it spins back into the net after that. No chance for Soetebu to play that one.
I think for Ito, we could say that was net positive. I'll be right back.
7-0.
I just heard a story about a friend of mine who was umpiring who had trouble throwing the ball to the player. We just saw one here that hit the bottom of the table and came rolling back. Creates an opportunity for a player to sort of cool off, take a little walk. Oh, it hurts. Just branded her name on the back of that ball. Scarring. The Mima punch is a knockout right here. Look how quick this is. Ah. Oh.
It looks like on that punch play, too, that she tries to catch it quickly as it comes off the table. It's not a whole lot of waiting around on that.
8-0.
Yeah, she won't let it rise. The more she lets it rise, the more opportunity and time her opponent will have, the less angle she'll have. Again, we see sweat squad again. that was a really sort of cute, shy, like, I'm really sorry. I'm working hard out here. I'm not trying to throw sweat at the table, but it just happens. I stay close. And she even tries to cool it off after to add dry to it. I like that.
8-4.
Incredibly polite. 8 points apiece.
Oh, that wasn't so polite. A blast down the line by Mima Ito to take the net lead at 9-8 here in game 3.
Go ahead.
Oh, I was just going to say that it reminded me of the Olympics in the mixed doubles when Mima Ito repeatedly called out the sweat squad to wipe down the table in the gold medal match against Shushin and Liu Xuan. That it seemed like almost to slow the game down to ask the sweat squad to come out.
It's funny because when the ball's in play, there is no slowing down for Mima Chan. That last forehand is devastating. Still a 2-point game, but 2-game points for Mima Ito.
Left. 10-8.
And that's off the net and out. And Mima Ito in game three.
Hypothetically, if they have an inverted or spinny rubber and a short pips rubber, they'll use the inverted rubber to serve almost every time.
Very interesting to watch her serve and how much wrist motion is actually in the strike. And it looks like, if you observe it closely, it's different every time. There's just slight variation in the way that she moves the wrist into the ball.
Yeah, she does an excellent job of varying up her serves to make sure that the receiver doesn't get too comfortable so that she can earn herself third ball attacks or outright points.
So let her be trying to reach over the table to slam it to the forehand, but missed, and now a 2-0 lead here early in game four for Mima Ito, just 21 years of age. There's a good example of that when she cuts under and spins side as well.
The strawberry.
Strawberry, okay. Well, I'll get there at some point. I thought I was going to. Well, I'll get my fruit straight here in a moment, Adam. But
yeah, no, we'll go over the food table in a minute. But yeah, she even, it looks like, you're right, it looks like she sweeps under, but she lifts the wrist to give it top and side spin so it accelerates fast to the corner. It's a very tricky receive. A handful of players on both sides of the game, men and women, use that shot very effectively.
3-2.
There at the trouble that tomahawk serve has given. So that you can see her hitting the top half of the ball, giving it top and side spin, but a low contact.
3-4.
It's an interesting short serve that time from Saweta Boots. Haven't seen much of that. Ito had a little trouble with it. Now just by 1-4-3.
Now we're talking. The lob just comes down wide. And she kept herself in this point quite well.
Yeah. And you're hoping, I think, as we've seen in the past, that lob comes down and just catches an edge and ultimately ends the point, but not there.
Dude, L4L, lobber for life. I love seeing my kind out there.
You know, Adam, in the point previous, Ito had what appeared to be one of those strawberry returns that was on the backhand, not the forehand on that time. But I don't know if there's a term for that one or not.
So both the strawberry and the banana use the backhand. It's just a question of which side spin is on it. There is one where Ito will come across it with the backhand and under, which is the same side spin as the banana flick, but with the underspin, we call it the banana split.
5-6.
If I'm making you hungry for more table tennis, well, order has been put in. That's right, on its way out.
Nice shot that time by Saweta Boot. Punched it down the line and ties things up here at 6-all.
You know, Mima Ito has a lot of strengths. Wingspan is not to her advantage, but she floats at the back of the table, so credit to Saweta Boot to find that narrow margin opening right on the line.
It's a good point, Adam. It may be why she is so jumpy and active as she plays. You almost have to be.
This is outstanding footwork from Saweta Boot. Ito takes all the pace off the ball with that brushing shot. And watch Saweta Boot. Hold on. Oh, that was from before. Soweta Boot moves in and attacks the ball right into the body. Now, I haven't seen too many losses from Mima Ito to foreigners, but I do remember after she dominated Ju Yuling in Sweden a few years back, four straight games, less than 5 points average for the Chinese superstar. Mima Ito got beaten, I think, Duhoi Kim in Austria. Back edge of the table for Ito, a bit of a break. But what Duhoi Kim did very well was spun the ball deeply to the backhand side of the table and baseline. And that's what we're seeing out here from Soweta Boot. She's spinning and making sure that Mima Ito, if she's going to use the backhand, takes some risky shots or takes the shots from deep.
Now, Soweta Boot has taken a 2-point lead here in game four at 9-7.
Short.
Great sequence that time. Ito, with some power play, pushed Soweta Boot off the table. But Soweta Boot never gives up on anything.
Yeah, she really had to chase in this point. She had a lot of reactions where she was just jumping and on one foot reaching to counter these flat shots. Not easy to rally with Ito.
Good return of service that time by Soweta Boot. Right into the body of Ito. She couldn't handle it. Now a couple of game points for the Thai player.
Yeah, coming out of the third towel break, she's going to be looking for any opportunity to get in early and put the pressure on Ito to drive her back behind the table and keep her away from that Mima smash.
And she does it. Closes her out on the first opportunity, and we have circumstance like this absolutely crucial, Adam. It starts well for Ito.
Well, it's definitely more crucial for Soweta Boot in the sense that head-to-head, while they are 50-50, the last time they played, Ito won 4-0 at the Olympic Games.
Nice recovery by Soweta Boot, but it was Ito bouncing back. One apiece here. Difficult ball to handle. It's one of those that's really close to the edge of the table. You almost feel like you're going to hit the table when you swing the racket.
Yeah, very handcuffing shot. Great placement by Soweta Boot. Hi, sorry. I left some of my labor on the table.
I'm gathering it is permissible when the sweat crew comes out and wipes down the table that you can take a towel, essentially you can wipe down yourself with the towel.
Just so you don't make anybody out there, sweat squad, I know they're very particular.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Don't want to get that wrong.
They have a big following. There are a lot of people with merch. Yeah, it's a long story, but sweat squad, we just have to show respect.
Don't want to get on the wrong side of that crew. As they're again off the top of the net, it has so much backspin on it, it just essentially prevents the player from the receiving player to receive it. It's almost like the perfect shot, Adam, off the top of the net, and there's just no way you can even get to it.
Well, now, even from behind the table, Soweta Boot trying to stay loose, keeping it at baseline with topspin. And you did say it right, this game will be a crucial game. And especially if Soweta Boot can take it, it'll put some serious pressure on world number three, the greatest threat to China, Mima Ito. See how much that ball turns. Looks like it changes its mind after it climbs over the net.
Left 2-5.
And even in the receive, Soweta Boot showing she can keep it tight as well, net for net. We got a turkey. One. Yeah, it's a turkey of Let Serves. Belated happy Thanksgiving to both of these two. Can we go for four? That's the question. Well, the serve clears the net, but the next shot clears the table, and it's Salweta Boot extending her lead to 4 points here, about halfway potentially through this game.
Vito coming back. She got Salweta Boot moving hard to her forehand side. Ball popped up, and Ito made short business of that one.
She did catch a bit of the net on that last shot. Otherwise, the ball might have been returned. So Salweta Boot's defense is, her defensive game has been very strong. That's clever. Ito changes it up with a short receive. Salweta Boot serves longer, deeper, gets herself ready for the attack, but was shut down by that receive. Not easy to return a fast serve short.
That half long shot again towards the edge of the table makes it difficult to feel like you're going to strike the table as you swing the paddle. You see the players miss under that circumstance quite a bit, Adam.
Yeah, and this one was a little bit longer, but you're right. And also in this atmosphere, the ball slows down quite quickly on the table.
Oh, big punch backhand that time by Ito. Draw within two.
So kick serve and Mima punch.
Really nice angle on that one as well, Adam. There's virtually no way you can get to that ball as Ito is able to drive it for her left to right.
Beautiful backhand here, really powering up. I mean, against Mima-chan, taking the opportunity when you have it is important. And right now, Salweta Boot playing very boldly. A long push gets back. The fact that Mima didn't open up against the long push is a bit surprising, but by playing it passive, Sutasini jumps on the opportunity.
Net 8-5.
Oh. Killer shot. Just really one shot and it's over. Jumps, we talked about her leaping before, but the trajectory of this ball is like a laser. Still a little topspin on it for that small bit of security, but just killed that shot.
Nice shot by Salweta Boot. Kind of that inside out spin going far to the forehand side, very difficult ball to handle for Ito.
Yeah, she takes advantage of just a little height, but that's a bold receive and very positive play. It's earned her a 3-point lead here at the business end of the game.
9-7.
Game to dump one into the net.
Yeah, no Miyage gifts. I mean, serves like this, it's just the pressure to make a tight serve. That's how strong the receive is of Ito. It's not, Sutasini could serve 10,000 balls in a row on the table, probably does every night for practice.
The backhand punch there by Ito that slips by Salweta Boot. And evens things up at 9 here in the pivotal game 5.
That's 3 in a row for Mima Ito. She was down 6-9.
What caused the miss there, Adam? It looked like it was in a position that Salweta Boot would have an easy opportunity to return that ball.
In the rally? We'll have to see a replay, but in all fairness, these moments right here, there's just so much on my mind, I can't even remember that point. I remember the service into the net, and this opening backhand here deep to the corner is really showing nerves of steel, gutsy play, and incredible focus point for point, erasing the past, playing each point like it's 0-0, and now it's game point for Soweto Boot.
Great battle in that point, and Soweto Boot just drops it into the net. Ito very confident on a game point against Adam, just very affirmative strikes.
Well, she had nothing left to do after this shot. Chases it on the run, spins it back softly. I mean, she had her back against the ropes, was hanging on by a thread, and chasing it down, spins it to the baseline. So here we are, deuce in game five.
And now with game point switching over to Mima Ito. Again, very aggressive play by Ito, very confident here in the late stages of game five.
She spent half of this match coming back. Game number one, down 1-5, came back.
Great point, and it's Ito. Good start for Soweto Boot. Nice punch on the backhand, deep into the forehand corner. And Ito, there's an example of the wingspan not being quite long enough to get to the ball.
Yeah, perfect timing from Soweto Boot to take that up high at the top of the bounce.
Great point, Mima Ito. Finishes off the side of the table, running from side to side.
Watch how short this ball drops off the back of the table. The recovery flat hit countered back, and the chase of Ito under the table. Soweto Boot able to scoop it up. Not much she could do. Maybe a snake from there, but outstanding feeling from Soweto Boot. Some of these rallies have continued a few shots longer than they look like they ever would. That's a great sign of both of these players performing well under pressure, just raising their level to get every ball back. Again, those hands, Soweto Boot recovering the net, playing it soft, keeping it low. At least relatively, I would say.
Another example where Ito could use a couple more inches to reach out over the table. Looks like her body caught the edge of the table and prevented her from being able to slam that down.
Set, two, or.
But just one. We've seen three in a row from you, Mima.
Beautiful shot. It does appear, Adam, from time to time that Soweto Boot is trying to get that angle deep on the forehand side when Ito, particularly, she's committed to the left side of the table because she can't get to those balls as easy as some players.
Yeah, combination play very well used out here. I say that to mean, much like in chess, it's some high-level thinking in advance. When you make a move, when you take a shot, you're thinking about investing in the future. What does that set me up for? So sometimes she'll play right to the middle on the elbow, see which way Mima turns, then maybe deep to the backhand. Here she's looking for the middle to try to create an opening to the corners.
Interesting serve there, kind of the slice backhand down the line and short by Soweto Boot.
There's that banana split. Tough to tell exactly what's on it. It actually looked like she played it right. The ball should have carried back onto the table with that spin.
Oh, a powerful exchange between the two young ladies and blasting it down the line is Ito.
She keeps some topspin on it, but really drives it deep. That ball was just about net height when she caught it.
You've made that point a couple times, Adam. It almost looks like it's flat, but she is getting some topspin that helps the ball drop onto the table.
Yeah, and she'll vary it up. From time to time, she hits it almost completely flat, but in that last replay, we could see the arc from down low. We had a beautiful camera angle for the replay. It's funny, if you're new to table tennis, the way the ball jumps out and kicks off of every bounce and the way it moves is very unfamiliar to non-tournament players.
Great receive by Soweto Boot. It was short to the forehand side. She had to reach out over the edge of the table to bring it back into play and did so perfectly. Evens it at five.
That combination is just too good. Fast and long to the backhand.
Quite a bit, yes.
Watch one more time. Fast long serve right to the corner, puts a little bit of side spin on it, hitting the inside of the ball to bend it out of reach. And she contacts it low. When you want to serve fast and long, the first bounce needs to be close to your baseline so that it jumps deep to the opponent's baseline.
Left, six, all.
Reaching out and firing it to the forehand side with Swedebu to take a 7-6 lead.
Yeah, her receive game has been very positive. She's been playing with a lot of initiative here to put the attack on the table and a timeout on the Ito side. Back from the timeout, we'll see what Mima Ito does down 6-7.
What went on that serve right there, Adam? What was the serve and what was the response?
Well, I didn't take a close look, but by the reaction, tomahawk, slight underspin with mostly side spin. Those are the pips on the backhand side of the racket, the red side, which Mima Chan will rarely use on the serve.
Oh, she used something right there, just a bullet right off the receive, almost as if she was anticipating that serve, stepped around and ripped it back to the backhand side.
That's absolutely right, she was. You could see her start to edge over that way. Had Soetabu played it short to the forehand, Ito would have been in trouble, but I think she would have gotten it.
Going farther and farther and farther out to the forehand side. Finally got it out of the reach of Ito to tie it up for Soetabu.
I see what you did there. Tie it up. Nice. Sutasini, though, on top of every bounce, staying right near the table, pushing Mima Ito away. At about 5 feet tall, Mima Ito does not want to be back. Remember, this is a fight for survival. Soetabu here trying to send this to the decider, game seven. If Ito takes this game, she moves on to the quarterfinals.
Kind of an uncharacteristic miss at an important moment by Ito.
Good pressure from Soetabu, deep and spinny.
Oh, Ito having to reach on both sides, but unable to keep it on. Brilliant play from Soetabu.
Yeah, that finishing shot was completely behind the momentum. It breaks the patterns. Watch this. One corner down the line, other corner, and inside out, she freezes up Ito by hitting it behind the body motion, and it all pays off to earn her 2 game points to send this to the decider.
And Ito staves off the first one with a very aggressive play. Set up on a nice shot down the line on the backhand side. And once it popped up, Soetabu backing down. But we've seen her when she backs, she doesn't give up. She's got an excellent lob to get the ball back on the table.
She does. I wouldn't consider it, you know, with Ito on the other side smashing. She just plays without the steady topspin. She'll play wide angles. It's tough to lob to her. 1 game point left for Soetabu.
Oh, and off the top of the net and long. Great point between the two players. Ito hanging in, but Soetabu right there with her.
Well, you can hear how the crowd feels about it. They know they've just witnessed world-class play under pressure.
How about the angle of that one shot on the backhand side that Ito had to reach out deep to get it back on? And Soetabu looked like she had the forehand side, just went off the top of the net long.
Lots of pressure. Here we are, deuce in game 6.
Got it.
And there, the serve goes long, and now we're going to get a timeout. Oh, she misses the serve on match point. How disappointing and unfortunate for Sutasini Soetabu of time.